BC, first in business worldwide.
Well, I know you've all been thinking hard about this one, but of course, before the break, we asked you which country was the world's biggest consumer of beer. It's not Germany, would you believe? And in fact, it's not even the US, which would come as a surprise, I'm sure, to many. It's actually China. And now the world's biggest beer makers are seeing declining sales in Europe. They're expected to make a renewed push into Asia, and that could be a big boost, of course, for beer stocks in the region. Adam Bakhtiar has been taking a closer look at this particular story. I'm sure you've been enjoying it. Did you get to do any beer tasting while you were doing your research?
You know, I've been to the Oktoberfest in Europe, so I know just how much the appetite is in terms of the Europeans to consume beer in that market. But it has been a big problem for the beer or the brewers in that region, because basically Europe is a maturing market. In the latest corporate earnings, whilst Carlsberg numbers were up 26% in net profits, they did flag concerns in the Western European markets. And this was pretty much mirrored in some of the other numbers that came out from the biggest players like Anheuser-Busch, InBev, SAB Miller, to name some of them. And all of them flagging sales dropping in the third quarter, even though they'll manage to protect some of their profit line margins because of increased prices in beer. But basically, we've seen that sales drop within that quarter between 4 to 5%. Why is it a big deal? Well, of course, Europe is a massive market for beer, and in fact, it makes up for about 30% of global production in general. So this is a concern to the mature beer producers in that region. But it's not just the Europeans that consume a lot of this stuff as well. Us Asians like our beer as well. And in fact, Asia has overtaken Europe lately to be the biggest producer, to the tune of 32.94%, overtaking the US as well. Now, in terms of Asia, the biggest producer, of course, and consumer would naturally be China, with 1.2 billion thirsty consumers. China has overtaken the US, and in the last 10 years has gone up about 104%. So the big beer makers are focusing on the Asian markets in general. But China is not such an easy market. It's rather fragmented. In fact, top three beer makers control only about 40% of the market. Snow controls about 20% of that market share, and it's often difficult to get into that market. Finally, this, of course, is stoking a lot of M&A activity in the region, and the Japanese know this all too well. In fact, the Japanese are the one that have been doing big acquisitions. Kirin has spent about $7 billion buying San Miguel, and also lately bought a stake in F&N, which owns Asia Pacific breweries, and that makes Tiger Beer. Of course, their market also has been maturing, and there's a lot of money to be made in Southeast Asia oil. 600 million consumers here. The level of urbanization, and of course, the increase in middle class, seeing a lot of Asians in Southeast Asia, of course, consume more beer, and you can make a lot of money for them. In fact, Thailand's third richest man, of course, I'm not going to try and pronounce his name because of the number of syllables in there, but he's the third richest man on the back of his company, Thai Beverage, which is actually listed in Singapore. It's worth absolute billions. From that market, and the Thais, they love their beer as well, I have to say. Back to you.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we certainly do in Australia too. Let's talk
yes,
more now about the opportunities in ASEAN in this space. Nagurnin Tiruchelvan joins us now. He's an equities analyst at Standard Chartered, joining us from our studios live over with Adam at the Singapore Exchange. Great to have you back with us, Nagurnin. Good to see you. Now, it's good to hear also that there are a couple of beer makers here in Asia that you're quite a fan on, in particular, I guess, given that we're seeing this, you know, some slowdown for a number of the bigger European and American players, given slowdown in that market and given the forecast that we're going to see China take on the top market.
That's correct. There are two principal drivers of beer demand in Asia. Number one, we see more young people entering working age. When that happens, there is an increase in demand for beer, and that is palpably obvious in a number of markets in this region. The second reason is that more people are entering a middle-class demographic, and that is clearly the case in Thailand and the Philippines, where the core of our recommendations are.
So then, where are the opportunities in terms of the M&A space? Because, you know, you're focusing, or, you know, a lot of brewers are focusing on Southeast Asia being a growing market here. But there aren't a lot of companies out there that one can acquire.
Well, the opportunities for acquisition are quite clear. There is a mismatch in the valuations between the emerging market brewers and the developed market brewers. The emerging market brewers, particularly those in Southeast Asia, are trading at a 30% discount to the developed market brewers. Right. In the developed markets, there is almost stagnation, right, or decline in beer volume growth. Okay. Over here in Southeast Asia, beer volume growth is growing at 6%. So that is where the opportunity is.
So you point out the discrepancies in the valuations between the brewers in the emerging markets in Asia and the developed markets. Give us some of the names, some of these big names that are trading at big discrepancies in terms of valuations.
There are two. There's San Miguel Corporation in the Philippines, right. And there's Thai Beverage right. in Thailand. Which is listed here in Singapore.
Do you think, based on the valuation metrics, that they are primary M&A targets, potentially for some of the bigger brewers in the developed markets?
They could be. It's unclear where the opportunities yeah. are in terms of the specifics of the yeah. M&A opportunity.
But why I say that? Yeah, why? Sorry, why I say that is because, I mean, Kirin, which is the biggest brewer in Japan, already holds a major stake in San Miguel. So, you know, there's stiff competition from some of these big companies to acquire stakes in the growing Asian markets, and I can't imagine why they'd want to sell their stake potentially in San Miguel Brewery, for instance.
It's unclear whether San Miguel itself would be the opportunity, but what I'm trying to highlight is that there's a mismatch in the valuation. Mm. So if there are greater M&A opportunities among emerging market brewers, at the very least, there would be a revaluation of companies like San Miguel right. and Thai Beverages, which are trading at a 20 to 30% discount mm. in a highly dynamic market.
Right. Oriel.
Nagunan, where exactly are these M&A opportunities that you're talking about? I mean, are they between these two particular companies? Are we talking consolidations with maybe some of the bigger European or the American players?
Well, the clear opportunity is that the four major brewing giants, such as Heineken, Carlsberg, and so on in the Western markets, are trading at a premium to the emerging market brewers. These giants are rich with cash reserves, and they have the opportunity to put those cash reserves to better use by acquiring emerging market brewers like the ones in Southeast Asia.
What about the ones in China? I mean, I was just looking through Reuters in terms of the valuations and came across Tsingtao Brewery. I believe Asahi Brewery has a small stake in that.
Yes.
On a PE basis, it looks extremely expensive on a forward multiple. I mean, 32 times versus the market PE of 17 times. That market is fairly fragmented. Are there opportunities in China, do you think?
There could be. The same dynamic of a mismatch in the valuations is apparent there if you look beyond the PE valuation.
But
I don't want to get into the specifics of the Chinese valuation because that is beyond our current ambit. But as far as Southeast Asia is concerned, there is this clear valuation mismatch of 20 to 30% where beer volumes are growing at over 6% versus stagnation in the Western markets.
Thank you very much for that.
Yeah, all righty. Thank you both. Thank you, Adam. Thank you, Nagunan. Good to have you with us today. Certainly interesting conversation.